Hello and welcome to Autodesk Simulation TV. In this 2-minute tip, I'm going to teach you all about bearing loads. My name is James Herzing and I'm a technical consultant here at Autodesk. So to define a bearing load, you need to do two main things. First, you have to set the magnitude for both forces. That's the thrust force and the radial force. Also, you have to set a loading direction for each of those. A helpful tip, these two forces can't be acting in the same direction. Let's go through the clicks in the software. Alright, so in the software, you see that we have our model imported, meshed, and we have our materials defined. So all we really have to do now is go to the Setup tab and click on the bearing load. Once we click that, we can see our dialog where we can define the thrust force and the radial force. Of course, we also have to choose the hole where our force is going to be acting. With that selected, let's click on magnitude, type in 100 and 150 just to differentiate them, and you can see that for the thrust force, the Z direction is already defined, and we're going to choose the Y direction for our radial force. If we click OK, we can then zoom in and see the representation of our bearing load. This shows you that the force is now acting in the Z and the Y direction. If we rotate this around a little bit, we can get a clearer idea of how this force is going to act on our model. The benefits here are that we're going to have a parabolic curve force acting on these surfaces instead of just a surface force that is acting in the same magnitude all over those surfaces. This is your tip on bearing loads. If you have any questions, reach out to me at the Sim Squad. Thanks a lot.